Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Let's Play No Man's Sky. So we are back, and we're going to kind of find this Nexus interface. I think this guy might be landing. So I learned that ships actually land, if you can believe that, at your base. There was a ship circulating when I was in my ship, just like sitting on the pad, and I was wondering if it was like a player trolling me or something like that. So without even looking to see if there's a player or whatever, I got out of my ship and I chased it down and shot it down, and then I was standing, and then I realized, whoops, it was an actual NPC. So they'll actually teleport out of their ship. There you go. How cool is that? I thought you guys would like that. I wonder if I actually can talk to them for language and stuff. Free language skills, you know? Buy from the life form, make offer for its ship. So you can buy and sell, basically, so... Oh! Well, we got that done. That is kind of hilarious. We needed to do that, but... I don't want to work on the scientific data stuff now, so you know what? Too bad. We'll just store it away because I don't want to deal with that. But we needed a dagger, you remember, for that one quest. So that's actually... That was just kind of a hilarious thing that happened. Okay, so let's get going here. So you could shoot this ship if you wanted to. I'm going to miss it anyways. There you go. And we're going to go to the stars, my friends. Okay, so I don't know exactly what we're going to do yet. Let's check the map here. So I'm trying to look for an Atlas station, destination Atlas station. So it actually has it popped up. So maybe it knows where we're going then. Oh yeah, here it is. So it's out of jump range. Yeah, we can only get so far. So we can get to this one and then we have to go to that one. Let's, oh, nope. Let's go to this one. I'm actually surprised I could jump because I don't... Oh, you know what? I did fill up my warp things. I built 8 more warp cells. Couldn't figure out... or 5 more warp cells. Couldn't figure out what happened to my other ones. And now I just realized I probably had already filled them up. So... Yeah, I did. Okay, whatever. So I have more now, which is great. Look at this cool planet. It's a yellow planet. It's a frost. Oh, so that's frozen water or something? I don't know. Cool. So yeah, we're gonna do what we're supposed to do when you first go to a new system, no matter what. So this is our new routine, in a sense. When we travel to a system in the future, when we're doing exploring, jumping together, I'll probably do this, like I'll say, okay, I'm gonna do our routine now. And I'll do this on my own, right? But for the sake of, you know, our Let's Play showing you what I'm doing here, I think that's kind of important. And then we'll just say hello, afternoon. And then we'll go off and do our routine. So our routine literally consists of this. We are going to run all the way up here. Excuse me. I'm a little slow, so forgive me. My poor feet, you know, old age and all. I mean, even real life, I'm not even fit to run this good anymore. It's kind of sad. I gotta get in shape. We're gonna go to this guy here and get our exosuit upgrade. By the way, I think this one might be a freebie one. Let's check here. So we got 239. I heard there might be a bug where it doesn't actually charge you, so let's see what happens here. 239. Yeah, it's not charging us. I wonder if the space station will. Okay, so what we do now is we run over here. No one even said afternoon to me. There's a bunch of people here. And then we're gonna go here. And we're gonna go to the local. So you'll know you're in the current one because it'll say... You're in the current one, I think. At least I thought it would. Uh-oh. Oh, I wonder if it'll work because I've never been to it. Hmm. My idea may not actually work then. Interesting. I don't think it'll work because we've never landed there. Ah, okay. So this didn't work out as well as I was hoping. So we're in the Discovery... okay, so we're in the system... Atisk. and I think we can actually do this. So I was hoping this could be like a routine, you know, I just go here. Because we've never gone to the space station before, it doesn't work that way. So I guess the first thing you want to probably do is go to the space station, then go to the anomaly after if you want, but... Either way, I might not even do it every time we travel. I might just save them up too, right? Be like, oh, I did this earlier today. I'm going to go do them off camera, something like that. But look at that ship. That's called an exotic. Exotics actually don't have as much storage as one would think. They look cool, though. Okay, so let's get out of here. I actually haven't, for a while, gone out of the anomaly for a bit. Because I usually teleport everywhere now. Okay, so let's go to the station now. So we got our upgrade there. I'm interested to see if the station one actually works. I need to get away from the anomaly a bit so I can... The anomaly is actually a lot bigger than one would think, so... There you go. So where is the space station? We should have been near it to begin with. It says the space station is... Okay, don't look at the... There we go. Look at the globe in the center instead. There we go. Yeah, sometimes I try to follow the compass instead, and I always get lost with it. But what you need to do is, at least when in a spaceship, use your center 3D map. Always is really useful. I'm actually really good at it. I even can use it to, like, find fighters and stuff. So... Yeah, I guess that's my own derping there. Nope, a bunch of freighters are available for purchase. Frigates, I should say. Freighters are the big one, which they are available to purchase, but frigates are the smaller ones. Okay, and then we're going to check this guy, because if he has a new scanner module, things like that, of course we want to buy that. So, always worth checking to see what he has for sale. And so we purchase this, and then we look through. I'm only caring about S modules, so there you go. There's an S one there. Don't care about anything else. So we're going to go and install that S one. So we're going to go here, install module, which will be great because this will be the good one here. So, of course, it's going to act up. So you can see it's not the best, but still better than what I have, clearly. So we just get rid of the old one, and then we move this one, and there you go. So now... With these stacked, they're pretty good. Like, this one's my favorite one. This one is not too bad for the flora, but the fauna is a bit down, and this one's kind of mediocre both ways. So, basically, now when I buy them, it's kind of like I'm going to replace one of these two, and then trying to, you know, min-max it, basically, over time, just to, like, squeeze out that little bit of performance. So, let's check here. We got 239. We're going to see if it gives us a free upgrade or if it also costs. I mean, it doesn't really matter anymore for us, but... I just want to see if the bug is just on the anomaly or not. So, 239. So, yeah. And the bug is everywhere right now. Basically, they do not charge you. So, I will put a bug report in there. I know some people will hate me for that thing. What a jerk, blah, blah, blah. But, honestly, that's I do report bugs. That's my kind of nature. I like testing, debugging, things like that. In fact, if I can get paid as a job all the time doing that, it'd be awesome. But you'd have to be doing it something you enjoy. If you don't like it... Oh, it would be so annoying. Because you have to put a lot of effort into it. Like, for example, let's just say you're doing... Oh, what's a good prime example that I can give you? Okay, so say you're testing for... It's just any game. Game A. And you would have, like, an Excel sheet, or if you're going to do it right, of, like, let's say, you know, 800 different features... And you'd go through all the features and test them. Now, if, you know, they're doing a certain area, you can go ahead and test, like, a certain area. But because that code can touch, like, 70 other areas, you got to make sure you go and test all 70 areas as well just to make sure it works without issues. I mean, that's, like, maybe more hardcore compared to what we see in testing these days. But it is a good idea to give you, like, you know, how to do, like, a decent testing, you know. Is that because I'm in there, I guess? I guess that just means, you know, there's a player there, or I'm there. Okay. Okay, so we're going to go down here. There you go. And this is where something's going to happen, probably. Here we go. So, the Atlas interface, which is a spooky thing. So, we're going to check this out. Now, I've never actually completed, like, the full stories of this. So, I'm looking forward to actually doing this properly and fully. I've never, ever done it. I mean, I've done this, talked to this, but I don't think I've done the full thing. Oh yeah, don't they have a revamp of this? Oh no, they have multiple stations though. I think. Wow. Even this looks new to me, but I don't think it is. It just looks so cool. I love the music. Wow, is this different than when I remember last time? This looks so cool. Oh, look at that. It has like a big ass door, like a window. That is so cool. And then there was pillars, wasn't there here? Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe these are nothing for this one, but... Yeah, I don't see anything actually opening, so I'm going to say maybe nothing for this one, but... Oh, so cool. Oh, here you go. Oh, yeah, there you go. That's what it is. These little orbs. You go near them, that's it. I don't even think you click them, right? There you go. So if you don't have a word for it, you learn it. If you already have it, well, you don't learn it, I think. That's how it works. So as time goes on, I mean, I've learned a lot of words, so I might not get a lot of good stuff out of this, but the idea is I guess you can get quite a few freebie words out of this. I think that's how it works. There we go. Looks like I'm not really getting lucky on the words here. Oh, the... Can I melee? What's the melee button? Yeah, that's the melee button. No, you can't. Just wondering if I can, like, get faster around. Oh, you can search this. What is this? Oh, a warp cell. Two warp cells. Awesome. So here it is. This is creepy, by the way. Blah, 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 blah. The Atlas called me to its interface, yet its purpose remains unclear. It demands worship. It demands obedience. It welcomes me. It knows what I am. It offers the gift of true understanding. But why? Why does such power and knowledge crave submission? It knows my thoughts before I know them myself. It knows what I will do. The Atlas asks me to follow its path. So accept the milestone Pathfinder or above. Accept the milestone. I guess, yeah. So there you go. I will accept this. The sky is deep and full of wonders, and the path to enlightenment opens to me. So a captured nanoid. Atlas seed containing zonally shifted blah 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 substance. Warning, do not allow matrix to commune with the dimensional of space. So I think this is actually used to... to probably get to a new area or something like that. No, I think it's actually a component that's required that you have to hand in later on. So, yeah, I think that's it. Pretty cool, huh? That's what it is. I think later on you need, like, certain components and to unlock something at one of the atlases, so... You get these like seed like components, I think, over time, and then you hand them all in. Pretty freaking awesome though. And there we go. So was there any planets on this one? Yeah, there is, right over here. Let's check it out, shall we? Doesn't look too special, but I want to scan it just in case. I should be scanning planets a bit more. Frost crystal, blah blah blah, high sentinel. Yeah, nothing too special in my opinion. Okay, so apparently we're going somewhere else, I guess. Okay, here we go. So we'll probably be flying to a new one. Okay, so we're going to be going backwards a bit. Which means we probably should go to a space station we already have been to. So, what do you think is closer? This one? Or I'd say this is probably closer in some way. So I might go here. So we're going to go to Yagami. I actually don't know. Visited. Yeah, we've been there, right? Like, I've used it multiple times. Just making sure. So we're going to go to Yagami. Actually, one more check. Yagami. And Souk. Okay, Yagami. Okay. Oh, you have to escape. There you go. And let's go to the space station here. So for fun, we're going to go through, you know, the procedure of what I was saying before. So we'll go to the space station. We'll dock at the space station. Let's do it. Where is he? He's going to be right behind the station? Yeah, he is. $200K. Let's see if we get the bounty. $239. There was a bug, like, we're talking about a million years ago, where you didn't get the bounty, so. I think it was actually in Nex, actually, but maybe it was even before that. Oh boy, he's gonna kick my ass, isn't he? I think we're gonna be fine, my friends. We overheated, but that's fine. As long as we can stay behind him-ish. Ah, he tried to dart at me. There you go. I'm not the best flyer, but I'm trying my best. I need more practice too, right? So, I like this arcade flying more than Elite. You should see me in Elite Dangerous. Well, there's a reason I don't have a Let's Play series. There you go. So 239, my friends. 439. We actually got the credit. Well, it actually shows up at the top there. And we got 5 Corvex standing for that. Ooh, that's beautiful. Boom, right through it. Yeah. That was cool. Okay, let's land. You probably noticed I'm going a little more uncut here. I don't like to do uncut things. That's not usually how I do it, but I'm learning to do it more, so hopefully you've been enjoying it when I've used it, but I think there's a time and place when it's useful, and I just don't want to, I guess in my opinion, I just don't want to overuse it right now, so. And I forgot where we're going, so I'm going to have to look at the map again anyways. So we'll go ahead and purchase this. Oh, I'm so excited. Just all the slots I'm unlocking. And then we're going to look at our casino machine over here. I'm calling it the casino machine now because now we... Well, there's 2 casino machines. Being able to find an S-class one. And then the being the one we want as well. So, nope, nothing there. So that's good. Saves us spending nanites. Something I don't really do, which I probably should do more, is pick things off the table, like navigation data. Even though I haven't been using it at all. There's been so much to do that I have, like, no need for it anyways, but... No, I don't want to sit. Ah! It's like, I know there's chairs now. It's an awesome feature. Now I think about it, was there even chairs in the friggin' Nexus? Come on, devs. Did you really not add chairs in the Nexus? That's the Atlas stuff. Okay. And then, I guess, routine-wise, right? Look at this ship. Freighter, I guess? Hauler, yeah. Freighter. Frigate. Yeah, freighter? No. Oh, freighter is what we fly, the big one. Okay, so now we're gonna go X. We'll spawn that in. But first, we're gonna go to the map because I derped up. Okay, so we know where we're going, I think. Yeah, okay. We want to go up there. So we were thinking of going to Yagami, and then, yeah, just Yagami, basically. Anywhere over here, honestly. Yeah, Yagami or our main base thing. I know, actually, that's not the main one, but you know what I mean. Okay. Yagami. Okay. Open sesame. Sorry, I had to get excited there. Okay. And then we're going to go and get our suit upgrade here. So this is where I would probably do a cut when we visit systems usually, but for this episode we're not doing any cuts. We're doing nothing but raw action. So we're going to go back here. Wait, is that a player? Players are solid. Okay, so we're going to go here. We'll purchase that. Excellent. By the way, this gun sometimes is sellable, sometimes it isn't. I don't know if it's a trigger thing or... Oh, maybe you have to click him and he sells it for you? Let's see. No. I don't know why sometimes I've been able to click that. I swear to you, though, I have before been able to open it. Anyways... We're going up here, and we're going to use this to get to Yagami. And then, yeah, so we'll go recent, and we'll go Yagami. I think that's the one I want. It is the one we're gambling on. Let's plug my phone in. There we go. Okay. Welcome to Yagami. I like how the LOD doesn't even load anything on this side. Actually, that's like frightening. Is it going to load when I get closer? It just didn't load at all. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, it was kind of crazy. First, I thought maybe it was really glitched. Since we're here, we'll talk to our friend here. Oh, gosh. Good day, sir. Yeah. Okay, so S-Class is scanner module. And anything else? Nope. Okay, we got another gamble. Let's do this, my friends. So, today's slot machine is brought to you by slotting. Okay, so we got, 6.9 and 8.4. So, 6.9, so it's... Oh, it's not better than that one, but it is better than kind of that one. Yeah, so flora, fauna, and flora. So the flora is slightly better on this, but the fauna is much better on this. So I'm going to go... See, that's when you're going to have to play with this. Like, but we'll go with this one, move it in there, and there we go. So you get the idea. And we do get parts out of there. I didn't really look at what we were getting. Actually, we could just look what it says. So what do we get out of part-wise? We get 40 chromatic and 1 wire loom. Eh. You know, it's a bit of credits. I mean, these guys are worth 50k each, so that's not so bad. And the chromatic stuff, well, I use it all the time, so I don't really care. Okay. Go, and then we're going to hit the map here, my friends, and we are going to see if we're slightly closer to our target over here, which, out of jump range, of course. Current mission. Why did I lose my... Oh, current mission. Destination, Atlas Station, there we go. So, 2 jumps. Much better. By the way, later on, you can get, like, drives that are more efficient, better, etc., etc. Use less warp fuel, you can jump further. So, like, there's things to look forward to. I think even the ships even have, like, a capability on that. Like, an exploring ship versus a non-exploring ship. So, look at this planet. Isn't that beautiful? So, this is just a frost. Magnetized ferrite. Yeah, it's just a regular frost planet. We're gonna check these out, because... It's too bad this data doesn't get, stored somewhat. We're just going to see if something, you know, really wets our palate. Highly energy planet, so gamma root, huh. Oh, uranium's there, so that's always good. And, this one looks like it's going to be like a paradise-like-ish planet. Humid planet, yeah. So high sentinel activity means you're going to have a lot of sentinels there to deal with. There's a planet behind this planet, which I can't see. No, okay. So, yeah, I'm going to do... yeah, we're just going to dock and do that stuff. Like I said, this episode we're not doing pausing, so... By the time the episode's done, we'll have made it to the Atlas station, but we won't have done anything crazy. I might extend it slightly just so we can, you know, take that visit to the Atlas station. But it's nice to finally get, like, you know, we're finally doing something with exploration wise, so. Okay, here we go. And then we're gonna go ahead and upgrade that. And even once you're done that, you got, you know, your technology slot, you got the cargo slot. I'll probably do technology first, just so I can, you know, load it up. Good day, sir. So what do we have today? I actually didn't look at my nanite, so I might not even have enough for an S. We have enough for one more S. If I need it. No, okay, we're good. There we go. There you go. And you'll get your little leg here. You'll probably notice it. Actually, there was a little leg I could tell there, but it did not stutter like sometimes it does. Sometimes it really has a big hit there, but this time it was pretty low. So I don't know if that means is, you know, it's lower than normal. Somebody's doing a Nexus mission. I actually want to do that with you guys eventually, but I need to not like right this second, of course, but. So lots of running around. It's kind of fun, though. I like the rinse and repeat type stuff like this, but I know for some people this probably drives them insane. But then again, you don't have to if you don't want to. You could just do it when they, you know, they come near you, kind of thing, you know, when you have a reason. And there you go. So we're gonna work all the way down here, and then I guess eventually work on another row. So if you click here, it should say, okay, no one's doing it, they must have canceled or whatever. What it'll say here is how many people are queued for it somewhere, like maybe in here, whatever. But it would just say the number there, so you probably already had left it or something like that. Is joining a mission at Nexus, huh. Didn't say it was starting, so... That's pretty cool looking little ship. What are you, a fighter? Yeah. 19-4, yeah. I like to look at some of the ships. All these are... Oh, that bug exists still. They're all 19-4s, aren't they? Yeah, they're all because of my ship. I remember this bug before. That was an X bug for multiplayer. I don't think it synced up correctly. Okay, so we're going to go map. Might have to get a certain distance, I think. There you go. And then we're gonna unhook here. And we're gonna do our final large jump up here, I think. And don't forget you can upgrade your ship like crazy, like, you know, its hard points and all that. Something I haven't done yet and something I'll eventually look into, but just want to remind you it does exist, so. There you go. Hello, Atlas. And I think this will be somewhat similar. It's going to give us the little beads. So the next time when we play, we're probably going to still be, you know, following this, you know, line, etc., etc. But what we'll probably be doing now is, like, we'll be skipping, like, the whole me going and getting my exosuit upgrades. So I'll just let you know I'm getting my upgrades and then, you know, go on with that. But, yeah. And let's see if we can learn anything new here. Even these are... You know what? I'll grab these, actually. These are something you guys don't need a witness either, to be honest. I won't try to overly cut things, but, like, you know, going around and touching all those balls might be a bit annoying. So there you go. More power, my friends. I like the free warp cells. I like that. It's a very nice gift. Okay, so the Atlas interface. How many of these constructs exist in the deep void? How long have they been slumbering, waiting for Traveler? Have they been expecting me? Am I somehow chosen? The Atlas has crafted this experience. The Gek, the Vakain, the Corvex, the stars that fills the skies, and the hatred that burns within the deep. Everyone would, every world that turns and every form that lives, the Atlas offers it all. So consent to milestone Juno or above. I take the gift of knowledge certain in my decision. All doubts are silenced. The stars await me. So we've learned a new product here. So you could do captured the nanoid. So that was what we got last time. And then pure ferrite to join those two. And there you go. Cool. And that's it for this episode. So I'm going to go around, grab these, and then we'll continue next time. And I will grab my suit upgrades off camera as well. So thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, comment, like. We'll see wonderful people next time. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.